no more export of domestic workers. We are not talking about the drivers, we are not talking about the bankers, we are not talking about the supermarket workers, we are talking about the domestic workers. Because once you enter that home of a chef, no one will be able to check whether you are sleeping, whether you are eating, whether you are being overused, whether you are being abused. No one will be able to do that. That's our concern.
What are your findings in a conversation that you had with the lady who was alleging that
She explained, and if you, I cannot expose her, but when she explained, I know she's seeing me talk or listen, she will get this program, but I'll not tell her name. She explained how these people suffer when they're in Dubai. And it's not only in Dubai, they're all over Middle East and other countries. And she said they are raped, they are used as a sex slave, sex items. There is real violence on them. They are treated inhumanely. And even the dogs, those people have animals like dogs sleeping on our girls.
So what was your role in ensuring that her life is safe?
When I got the information that she was at the airport, she not related to me. She got my phone. Of course, my phone is public, and luckily enough, that time I picked it. She called me that she was arrested at the airport in Dubai because her visa had expired. I had to cross-check with the police. I pleaded with the police. I said, kindly don't take her in. We're going to make arrangements for her to come. And when they was there, because sometimes people tend to use us, and still, I had to use my international contacts. I got somebody in Dubai who went at the airport and confirmed that the lady was there, even sick. So when we paid, we had, at that time now, Emirates, time for leaving, the time when it passes, the visa expires. The ticket expires. So we had to arrange for her to come the following day. So we had to pay the $600 they wanted and bought her a single journey ticket from Dubai to here. And I spent $1,050 to make her come here. And when she came, she gave me these stories. I felt so bad, but unfortunately I'm not in power. The only thing is to ask government, which is part that kindly don't do what you are doing to our ladies, the young girls, who are my daughters, or even the boys, I'm sure they are suffering. And we believe the jobs here, which could be done by our Ugandan children, but are being done by people like Indians, Chinese, mention it, at the expense of ours who are now being exported.
You say that with the conversation that you had with the lady, it was made clear to you that they are subjected to sex with dogs.
Yes.
Can you narrate that story?
Yeah. I've told you, how can I narrate it? A dog sleeping on a girl, it's very unfortunate. It's very unfortunate. How do I narrate it? You want me to do it? I've told you a story how a dog sleeps on a girl.